Hi everyone, and welcome to another short video. Godot 3.0 was officially released this week. Our OpenVR module was also made available in the asset library, and in this video we will quickly walk through setting up a project using it. It currently works with Windows, and the Linux version should be going live soon. Let's start by creating a new project. As always, we first add a root node to our scene. Then we save the scene as our main scene. Open the asset library by clicking on the button in the center top of the window. Now search for the OpenVR module and install it. If you don't need all the files in the module, you can untick some of them, but we will grab all files. Next, we'll import a subscene that is part of our module called OVR First Person. This adds all the nodes to our project needed for a first person VR experience. We turn on editable children. This allows us to add our teleport and direct movement functions to our controller placeholders. Now we'll add a floor to our project. In preparation for our next video, we are going to add a collider to the floor. We start by adding a static body node to our world. We then add a collision shape, and we will use a plane for this. Finally, we add a mesh instance with a plane mesh to complete our set of nodes. We'll change the dimensions of this plane and subdivide it so our individual polygons won't become too large. Let's rename our nodes to something sensible. I am going to write a shader that adds a pattern to our floor. I could use a texture for this, but this is more fun. We start by creating a shader material and then add a new shader to it. We set our shader type to spatial. We then add a uniform that allows us to scale the UVs. We can set the uniform from outside the shader. We're only changing the fragment shader, which is implemented as a function. I'm calculating the modulo of our UV coordinates at two different scales. The modulo gives us the remainder of a value divided by another value. We are dividing by 1, so we will end up with a value between 0 and 1. That repeats over the length of our material. We want to use a white albedo color when the x or y value of our modulo becomes small, else we'll use a dark color. Note that our white becomes bluish. This is due to the reflection of our sky map on our floor. We can make the material look much nicer by changing some more properties of the material, but I will leave that for another day. The shader creates a grid pattern, the size of the ribs changing depending on the values we choose. We now repeat the same process to create a cube with a collision shape. I'll speed through the creation of this, as the steps are very similar to creating our floor. Instead of a plane, we now use a box shape as the collider. Note that this shape becomes twice as large as the dimensions you give it. For the mesh, we use a cube mesh. I want to reuse my shader for my cube. We select our floor and save our shader to a file on disk. At this time I realized I put my mesh instance in the wrong spot, so quickly drag and drop. Now we load our shader into our material in our cube. Finally, we adjust our material scale. I'm now going to separate out our cube into its own scene. This will allow me to instance the scene a few times around the world. I'm planning to add more objects into our scene in a later video. The idea here is that our teleport function and our movement function will eventually interact with the collision shapes. Our final task for today's video is creating the familiar four lines of code in a script on our root node that initializes the OpenVR module and turns our viewport into a viewport capable of outputting to our HMD. One thing I forgot to record is turning off VSync in the project settings, as this limits the FPS to your monitor's capabilities. We can now run our project to see our end result. It is not as pretty as the Sponza demo, but this will be our starting point for extending the capabilities of our implementation. I hope you enjoyed this video, even though I had to repeat a few things I had already covered in previous videos to demonstrate the new asset. Until next time!